Hello guys, today I want to take a look on all the apps which are available on the Fitbit Ioniq by now. And this is the last days of April 2018, so if you watch from the future, it may not be up to date. Also, this is the view for Europe. Some apps are still US exclusive, for example the Pandora app and the Starbucks app. And there's also probably Adidas app, which is exclusive for the Adidas edition, as far as I know. Let's start. I try to not go into all the apps, and hopefully the video will not be too long. Also, I had been sick and down with a bad cold the last days, so I hope my voice does not break and I can avoid coughing. So, start with Share a Bike. This is an app for a bike sharing service, which is available in several cities, as you can see here. Like even in Europe, and so in case you're using the service, it may be interesting, but it's not available all and everywhere. So Metronome, probably interesting for music, so it makes the clock, the watch vibrate every couple of beats. A sports tracker app, which I can't say anything. I think Sarajevo Bus is probably an app for the bus in Sarajevo, which should not be interesting for too many people. Barcodes, no idea. You can store up to 5 barcodes. So you need a phone app, and then you can save the barcodes on your watch and can show them on the watch. Not quite sure for what it is, but maybe if you have some barcode scanner somewhere and you need to carry a barcode around, could be interesting. Or something like a Groupon or some stuff, calculator. So not really. From Surfline, this is an app for a weather app for surfing. With all the weather and stuff apps, you have to be aware that the Ioniq itself does not have an active connection without your cellular. So much stuff which is needs internet information is not working if you don't have your cell with you. So yeah, that's to be noticed. Coin tracker to keep track of your virtual currencies. Pill Tracker, this is an app for tracking your medication. I think this has also been, this was one of the very first apps on the Ioniq. So not really interesting for me, but if you have to take a medication regularly. My Water Lodge, probably a game. Oh no, it's for logging your water. So log in the water is meaning that it's HR passing some heart rate related app. So they it's quite interesting. Maybe I tried this out sometime. So stuff like your resting heart rate. Hydrate is probably another water tracking app. Yep. Velocity. Smart digital compass and speedometer from the onboard GPS. Can use it for a sailboat, yeah. And this could be something I may could also try out. If the music app is from Fitbit itself, or I've talked about this on length in another video. Want on time. It's actually watch face. It's a watch face which keeps your screen on all the time, so your battery will run out dry very fast. Treasure Tech, let's see. This is a game from Fitbit itself, it seems. You're playing with your steps, so it could be interesting. Deezer is a music streaming app. It's the first of its kind for the Ioniq. But you need to have a paid subscription on Deezer to use it, and it was actually forceful installed with the update. I think they were very proud that they finally got a streaming service for us. Tube Status was good. London Underground Tube Line, so only interesting for guys. Tips, this is This was also introduced with the update, probably to show you what was changed. 15 puzzles, just some games. I'm not so interested in games on the Ionic, to be honest. Torch is probably one of the Torch or Flashlight apps, which are quite useful. I have one installed. Does work much better than the cell phone flashlight light with the flash or the screen. Just turns your Ionic screen all the way white, and this works really fantastic. And QR code. Then you can create QR codes on your Fitbit, and then probably have them scanned via cellular and share stuff that way. Another calculator, probably a bit difficult to use with the small display. New York Times, the news feed for you. For the Ionic, same problem as with other apps, you need your cellular virtual partner. I think there's something for running, probably not what you guys think. Some running app. UK Transport, probably for transportation in the United Kingdom. It's train departures in the United Kingdom. Mine for me is probably something for food tracking. That's all. Eating more slowly, same, yeah. Tier of calendar. Daily events from your Google Calendar. Quite tempted for me. Drink counter. That on. So probably you can track how much you did drink. This is the Hertha Sutra, so you can read a book on your Ionic. Actually, Pomodoro timer interval. It's a Pomodoro timer, so probably something like HIT. I've seen the term, but it's another flashlight app. There's about a dozen of them. Starver is quite clear. So there's the app which was there. I think as far as I remember it, it only can check your Starver stats with it, so it's a bit strange. Nightlights probably. Yeah, this is another flashlight app. Yep. Just not sure how it does get this information. You cannot really see it here. Probably needs an active connection as well. Golf range. Yeah, then you can use your Ionic for playing golf. Flipboard news for you, another news app. Calculator, have seen quite a lot of them. This is an app where you can use your smart home devices. If you have an IFTTT webhook. What could be? No idea. Heads or tails. Other than you can flip a coin virtually. Yeah. Honest random results. Think fast. This was also one of the very first apps. Yeah, 2 minute games to test your abilities to think fast. Find my car. Full functionality can be used by paying $1. So Salty Dog, something for sailing again. Also shows the speed over ground. So this seems to be a real use case, since there are already two apps out there. And probably in that regard is probably quite useful, I could imagine. MySwim Pro, swimming workout tracking. app. Bubble level, this is probably a game. Oh no, it's this, yeah, it's for leveling stuff. Stopwatch, I think that's quite clear. We haven't touched it. No idea what it is. It's for a favorite station. I have no idea for what this is. Seems like, could imagine that it gives you the frequency for a radio station, but pace calculator, sound training. So a special training app which does help you keeping the special hardware zones or something like this. Yeah. There's probably some other calendar app. Yeah, we have had already one of those for Gmail calendars, Wiki places. Should I have maybe noticed it in the intro that this has some crossover with the Versa. So can you can fit fine short, but then you also need you have to set your cellular close by and why watch it on the small screen if you can do it on the big screen. A live counter for Magic the Gathering. Yeah. Puzzle game for switching flips. Ah, the Koran. Why would anybody? Maybe if your phone is out and you want to read something, yeah, maybe it makes some sense. I think the Hue Lights app has been there around quite a while. So, for controlling your lights, the Berlin Transport, a skate. This sounds like a skating app. Yeah, can game play a game. Rain, is this something weather related? Oh, yeah. Rain shows your graph of the upcoming rain. Next hour, so worldwide it only shows for the next 2 hours. And USA, UK and Ireland, you get good data. Belgium, Netherlands, 1 hour, for 2 hours. It's one of those apps where you need your cell period tracker. Actually, yeah, no idea. No, just for the girls. One more stopwatch. Watch CVS card. Yeah, this is this the about the same as the I was talking about the usability of this of this barcode app, and this is the same, just only for CVS. But we had have a use case for the other app. Another train app, United Airlines. I think they show you flight information for United Airlines. Swiss Transport, we already did. Hit is probably a hit. Timer for interval training, yeah, right. The wallet is very limited depending on the country. Outside the US, you have really to check if it's even available at all or if your bank does support it. Altimeter, this is showing you the sea level or based on your GPS and on the barometer data from the Ionic. This is a $2 app for hit and for hit workout notes. See, Google Drive account. Shows you your Google Drive accounts. My again, that's probably another Google calendar. Oh no, that's own. This one does also work with Microsoft Calendar. And they want a $2 payment as well. It's simple. I think DICE is quite clear. So, does it do? 20 numbers. Can you do a D20 with this? Quite sure. Nothing. This is could be interesting. This is where you can control your camera via the Ioniq. So you can use the Ioniq as a remote control for your camera, and probably especially for a cellular camera. And this can be useful if you do stuff like night photography with your cellular. World clock with time zones. What is this? Oh yeah, Kibler. Prey times and compasses. Badminton counter. Yeah, there you can track your score. Travel times versus from. Okay, no idea. Exercise, the usual feedback, air index, probably showing you how good the air is. Yes, just for the US. They just ask a donation, which is much nicer. One more calendar app. Triathlon, it's probably a workout app. This video is already too long. Irish Mail, I think we don't need to check that. Bragging rights, what is this? Oh yeah, this is absolutely useless. For Bilbao's cycling community. But yeah, only for Bilbao. Stuttgart Transport for Germany. Yeah, one more calendar app. This app was also around quite, I think, when the app came around, so to help to split your bill and stuff. One more golf app. Leaderboard is also from Fitbit to compare with your friends. Hopping balls. Yeah, should try this out. Maybe this works. No, locking. They have to click it, else it's not working. One more heart tracking app for Upvito. A Dublin bus is also clear, I think. Maps, one more app, Maps app. So it have to be downloaded beforehand, okay. This seems to be a game. Okay, no idea. Yeah, this is probably to track your baseball scores, yeah, when you're out there on the court. Cadence Coach, probably workout app. Yeah. Looks a bit like interval training. Air quality, we had already one of those. Tomacina, what could this be? One more Pomodoro timer. I really should keep track on the trends. Telecounter. Pressure is probably showing the air pressure from the barometer. Yeah. In Pascal, Weathercast, a photo album watch app. What's this? The Fitbit. Probably this could be nice to get like your family pictures on there or something like this. Transit info is probably. This is for the DC metro area. 911 ID. Just like your emergency information. But I think this does bring the problem that I'm a volunteer firefighter, and I don't think I would check your badge if there's any information on there. Unless you put a pledge there and say, vocabulary skills, one goal, some running app. This looks like a game from first glance, a puzzle game. Tips for Ah ja, das was the one I was talking about, I think, oder? Ja, for splitting the bill. I think I can calculate too good in my head. Yeah. So to check Bitcoin and other currencies. No idea. The Magic 8 Ball. Just it's certain. Yeah, okay. Why did I even a suburb quark like 9 block T-twist to relax up from Fitbit to control your breathing and can help you get down squat track pro you can track your score for your whatever game tight table chart is this shows you the tight for surf, dive, go fishing, yeah. I see that this could be useful. It's something you come not so easy by. World clock. This is more to do with the watch faces than with apps actually. A metronome, yeah. Once more, yeah. Probably gives you Bitcoin or that one more. Bitcoin tracking, game of colors, Tabata timer. We have seen those quite a lot, just with other names. Run outside, but Hong Kong only. Astrofit, let's just check if this is a game. Yeah, it's quite clear. But I think one which used your steps. Let's just go back. Let's see. No, not really. Use the Alcometers. Fit lift. Yeah, this could be useful if you're doing weightlifting. Moon calendar watch. Yeah, this is more of a watch face than a watch face one. I'm not quite sure. Scorekeepers probably also. Yeah, for keeping scores in a game count. Can count everything from apples to melons, but not mangoes. Never that. The moon. Yeah, my kids really like the moon, so could be interesting. Yep. See. Then you can see reviews, HR report. Need 7 days to. One more metronome with the cat. Put the time in air. Yo, this. What is your. Again, you can send messages to your friends from. But they need the Yo app, of course. So you can send short messages like on the iPhone. So, probably. If somebody's running, this is a game, it seems. Gym motivation. I think this gives short quotes to motivate you. Not quite sure. Cardio doc. For better understanding of heart rates. Still, just a question if you want to, those guys to get. This is for tracking foot. Yeah, the Fitbit own foot tracking is a bit lacking in my eyes. Never needed time help to time my squeezes while I was donating blood. So when I'm donating blood, another bill split app. I don't need to go into tennis. This is actually from Fitbit itself. So for tracking tennis scores. Another calendar. This is the flashlight that I have installed. I imagine they are all quite the same, but it's really useful. So one other cryptocurrency tracker. Fitbit timers. Not another calculator. Flashlight. customizable, probably. So you can contact them and they make a customized app for you personally. No idea. Another Bitcoin tracker, Ionic Water, another water tracker. Come on, we don't need to watch this. The stock tracker, we're already at the end. Another beat counter, travel times, this looks so familiar. No. So, as you saw, we have, as always, we have some stuff which does repeat. Some of the apps seem super useful for specific stuff, some others are quite questionable. The question is always how good, or I think the most best apps are always those which you could actually use without your cell phone. So like for example, I think a news app doesn't really work so much on the Ionic, because when I want to read the news, I read it on my phone, and if my phone is out of battery, my Ionic only has yesterday's news. So yeah, old news, so it's not so interesting. On the other hand, some stuff can be useful where you don't need to push out your phone. So for example, calendar stuff is actually can actually be useful if you get your stuff up, in my opinion. I think the sailing stuff is probably from people who are really using it for this. And I see it's stuff there, but I haven't sailed like since my late teens. So, no real insight from me there. Yeah. So some apps are really useful, some probably are not. Selection is still not very not very high, but it's much more than it was before, and it seems to develop, so there's something coming, and I probably have to redo this video in a couple of months, but then find out a way to filter out the apps I already covered here, I think. Yeah, thank you guys for watching, don't forget to subscribe. I hope you enjoyed the video. My voice actually managed to, but I have no idea how long this video is by now. It's probably way too long, so I won't drag it on any longer. Thanks, guys. See you soon. Don't forget to subscribe. Bye-bye.